On this segment, we are talking about the Rush Hope Foundation, and I'm here with Betty Rush from the Rush Hope Foundation and John Freed. And thank you guys for taking a minute to be with us. And let's start out, you know, Betty, maybe you could tell us a little bit about what it is, because this is something close to your heart.
Very much so. Thank you. The Rush Hope Foundation was founded to assist individuals and their families recover from the effects of addiction.
It's not always easy. So when we talk about that, John, you know, what are some of the things that happen here? First of all, tell us where we're located.
Yeah, this is our main location, 600 West Broad Street in Quakertown, Pennsylvania. But we cover the Tri-County area, Lehigh County, Montgomery County, Bucks County, mainly Upper Bucks, but we extend to the Tri-County area.
If someone has an addiction, what are some of the things that they encounter which lead them to here?
Well, most people who are suffering with addiction are in need of support services that extend beyond treatment. So the goal of the Rush Hope Foundation is to make sure that people have access to those services. So there is education, prevention, intervention, but there's also the ability to be able to provide them with longer term recovery support services. And when we say longer term, we're looking at, you know, 6 months to 2 years of case management, you know, recovery planning, just basic assistance and addressing the underlying causes of why people have addiction in the first place and why they continue going back to the drug or the drink. The ideal is that we're going to help them heal the underlying cause so that they don't return to the drug.
So John, what are some of the programs?
Well, we have four main programs. There's individual recovery support, there's family support, there's veteran support program, and there's youth in crisis program. So a brief summary on each one of those four. Individual recovery support, that's probably our main one. We help with individuals directly affected by addiction. And a lot of times, guys just kind of white knuckle their way through it, but like Betty said earlier, you need to address the underlying issues that are causing the addiction. The actual drug use, alcohol use, it seems to be just a byproduct. It's a way to self-medicate. So one of the main goals in the individual recovery support is to figure out what it is that's going on, whether it's depression, anxiety, something going on internally in the family structure, and we try to help guide and navigate through those times to see that light at the end of the tunnel.
So is this just for guys or girls too?
It's for guys and girls.
Let's talk about maybe an example very quickly of what someone encounters. So these people that are just gotten stuck on prescription drugs or other drugs, or how does that work?
Yeah, exactly. For instance, there was one individual a few years ago. His pelvis was crushed in a motorcycle accident. He was prescribed opiates. He got addicted to opiates. He wanted to stop taking opiates, but what do you do with the chronic pain? We try to help facilitate or guide or navigate through what to do, what other alternative solutions are there to that chronic pain aside from the opiate, because the specific individual, they can't take opiates because it just spirals out of control.
Well, another one is trauma, any kind of trauma. So if people are dealing with psychological trauma, in order to recover from that, they're not going to deal with that or delve into it in the first 30 days of abstinence from drugs or alcohol. And that's why the 6 months to 2 years is necessary, because people need to build resilience before they can start delving into the past and what it was that caused the pain in the first place. So John talked about physical pain, but this is the psychological and the emotional pain and that scarring. And that's where we're talking about healing the underlying causes.
Cost. How does that play into this? Do people have to fund it themselves? Is there funding available?
In some cases, we can help financially with certain aspects of an individual's recovery. Most of the time, we find that people suffering from addiction aren't very financially stable. They don't always have insurance. The insurance that they may or may not have isn't always the best insurance. So a lot of times, they're going to need financial assistance. We have a long-term rapport and relationship with a lot of service providers that are involved in the recovery community. So if we can't necessarily help them financially, we can help set up kind of like a payment structure for them to help, like a discount almost.
So Well, I think it's really important for people to understand that those partnerships and the ability to be able to raise funds, obviously through business, through personal donations, that's one of the ways that we help fund this. Also, some people may have those resources but don't know how to get connected. But when it comes to the finances, you know, the need is great, but in the long term, the payoff is a lot better because now people aren't going back to jail. They're not committing crimes. You know, there's a cost to the community for addiction, and there's a cost to the family.
Addiction, it's tricky. It will make you think that it doesn't exist. If you have an issue, come to us. We'll do everything we can to help you. But addiction's irrational, and it can be difficult to do it on your own. You don't have to.
The final word, I would say that addiction sometimes comes with an idea that people do not, it's not a true statement in the sense of not everybody who's addicted is living underneath a bridge. A lot of our neighbors, 1 in 4 families are affected by addiction. The best thing is for people to understand that people can and do recover, and it just takes time. It takes understanding. This is a human disease of mind, body, and spirit. And if we address it, mind, body, and spirit, people will and do recover.